Welcome to Enoch's Engineering, I'm Alan. In this video we're looking at the 3 jaw chuck regrind. I did it a few years ago, probably about 4 years ago, but it does get a lot of wear. And I have had trouble recently in job running true. So I measured the jaws and found that one of the jaws was about 1.5 thou in a different position to the other two. They'd all got wear on the front of the jaws, so I thought now's the time to regrind the jaws. Last time I used the ring method on the outside of the jaw. This time I'm using the bush method on the inside of the jaws. And we start off by parting the bush off and then I explain the setup. So let's go into the workshop and see how we do it. Noticed recently that my 3 jaw chuck was not centering as well as it used to, and I run a dial indicator along the jaws and I found there was over 1 thou taper in the jaws, more on the very end where you grip all the time, and I noticed there was some run out in the jaws as well. So I've decided it's time to re-grind the jaws, and last time I ground the jaws I used this ring that went on the outside, opened up the jaws to grip the ring, and then I could get in and grind the jaws. Now with this ring method on the outside, I've had people say, no, you're not loading the jaws properly, it won't be as good as using the jaws to grip. I've seen people using bits of metal between the edges of the jaws gripping on the 45 degree of the jaws, but I'm wondering how accurate those jaws are machined at 45 degree. They may not be accurate, all they're there for is clearance so that you can actually close the jaw, because you don't actually grip on the 45 degree part of the jaw. So if that's not accurate on the 45 degree machining, then you could be gripping one jaw slightly further open than the other jaw, and every time you put a piece of work in the chuck you've already got a built-in run out. This time I'm going to try a different method. I've made this bush. The main thing that you need to do on the bush is get a reasonable finish so your jaws can grip on this. It needs to be thick enough that you're not going to crush the bush. And it needs a shoulder on the bush so that you can push it up to the shoulder from the back of the chuck. The other thing you need to do is make sure it's just with this chuck, this shoulder is just under the diameter of the inside of the chuck. So I can put the bush in, bring it back forward. And lock the jaws on the bush. Now the idea of that is that I can now, with my grinding wheel, grind the front half true, take the bush out, and put the bush in on the front that's been ground true, and the hole in the bush is big enough to let the grinding wheel go through, and then you can grind the back half out. So what I'll do now is set my grinding wheel up to line the centre of the rotor zip spindle with the chuck. I've put a collet in, gripped a piece of round bar, so if I push the bar in it won't go in, slacken the chuck off. And you can see it's pushing this jaw up. That tells me my rotor zip is too high, so I just lower it a bit using the tool height adjustment. It's not pushing it now, so I can tighten the jaw up a little bit more until that goes in without pushing just pushing the jaw up, move it up on the top. Just pushing the jaw up so it's just a little bit too high. Lower it down in the tool post. Tighten the jaw up a bit further. So when you can move it into the chuck and just grip the bar, you know you're on centre line. Collet it off the end. That's all it was, to collet it in the rotor zip with a piece of rod in. You could do it the other way, hold it in the chuck and then get this to fit in the rotor zip. Like that. Doesn't matter. Check that this bush will go through, so that even the nut will go through the bush. Tighten the collet. The first thing to do is dress the wheel. I open the chuck. This is a diamond I'm using. Let's put it through the jaws of the chuck. I've just gripped the diamond in the chuck and now I'm turning it round so that the diamond is on centre line with the wheel. Now that's ready to press the wheel, but before I do that I want to put some cloth over this to stop the dust getting everywhere. And just under here I fitted my vacuum hose. I'm hoping it'll catch most or suck up most of the grit. The chuck just stays still and I move the wheel backwards and forwards across the diamond. So I have my safety glasses to prevent any bits of grit getting in my eyes. Vacuum's on. There are some reasons why you dress the wheel. The first reason is to remove any material that's clogging the wheel and give the wheel a good cutting edge. And the second reason is because it was removed from the collet, it's truing the wheel up so it's running through and not going to bounce on the workpiece. I just need to take some more off the wheel so it will go through the bush. The bush that I'm using in the chuck just goes onto the wheel. Now I can set the chuck up for grinding. And the chuck jaws are just gripping on the bush. Now I'll mark the jaw up with some felt tip pen. So I can see when it's ground. So look how that looks. this time I'm going to grind on the back jaw here, so I'll be moving towards the back of the machine. And that's because if I'm grinding on this jaw at the front, all the bits of grit and dust will come up into my face. I can't lift it up and down to grind on the top jaw, so the only way I can do it is either the front jaw or the back jaw. So I'll move the rotor zip towards the back and then go in and out once it started to touch the jaws. I'll just turn the chuck on, turn the rotor zip on. You can see there it's just grinding on the one jaw, which is what I expected, and it's not touched the end yet. You can see it's touching on the back, and the first jaw it's touched all the way along, so I just need to take a few more thou off till the other two jaws are the same. Now you can see the first jaw has gone all the way along, the second jaw it's nearly to the end, so I'm just taking that's wearing the jaw, and the third jaw is the same. So I had one jaw that was slightly out to the others, so I reckon another thou and that should clear it off. See there now, all the jaws are clear, so they've all been ground. What I need to do now is move the bush to the front. I'll set my DRO to zero so I know exactly where I am. Clean the dust off the bush. Reset the bush to the front. push the grinding wheel through the bush. I think that's okay. Let's check the run out. Three and a half run out there. That's about 7 inches away from the chuck. So we go about halfway. It's around about a thou. Each division, each small marker on there is a tenth. So there's 10 to a thou. And then at the chuck, tenth. I'll try that and see how I get on with it.
Oh well, that's it for today. Hope that was interesting, hope it was enjoyable, and if you liked it, why not subscribe? And we'll see you next time on Enoch's Engineering.